What is up, Ant fam? It's your boy John from Ant Mate, and today we're gonna go for a bit of a lazy video. This is just something I wanted to do for a while. We've been collecting a lot of ant colonies, and today I'm gonna show you the weekly grueling 2 hours that I spend feeding some of these ungrateful dogs. Are you ready, guys? Because I got some real dope ants to show you. Starting with our Campanatus Consobrinas. Have a look at the queen. Isn't she absolutely off the rails? She's not even waiting for the food. She's just digging right in, doesn't even care. So these are banded sugar ants. They're one of the more pretty and exotic species we get in Australia. Very aggressive. They spray formic acid like most Campanatus, and as the name suggests, they really, really love sugar. But I think the queen has a problem with that cricket leg. Don't think she likes the cricket leg. Moving on, these are our Campanatus cans. As the name suggests, they came from Cairns, or C.F. Marquens. That's the closest actual Campanatus we can find that fit the description, but they're not really Marquens. They're not actually identified. And we know that because we went through about 400 species of Campanatus that are found here in Eastern States Australia with the Discord group. So shout out to Jash and Mama June and Belf and all the other fools who helped us fail to identify these ants. They're about 2/3 the size of the other Campanatus we have. They grow a bit faster and are a lot more skittish. Watch this fool fall from the ceiling. Next up to the dinner plate are our Campanatus nigriceps, and as you can see, they also love sugar because they are also sugar ants. And one of them has a big dent in her butt, which is a bit concerning, but it's something I've noticed on quite a few ants, and not sure if it's a bad thing, but it doesn't seem to affect them in any way. And here you can see they're feeding their mum. They're using trophallaxis to vomit the food back up into her, so yeah, it's it is what it is. Ants are what they are. Now this is a bit more of a familiar face. Not so exciting to watch them eat at the moment. They hibernate a lot, but these are our Natonkus colony of about 150 or so, give or take 50. I don't know. We've recently moved them into this new setup, and as you can see, it's a bit of a ghetto setup at the moment, but we're trying to get them into this dope Ants Australia nest, which one of them seems to have the idea, but the rest of them kind of stuck halfway. So they're a bit between homes at the moment. Not quite homeless, but yeah, they're kind of split between two test tubes and a pipe connector. So hope to sort that out soon. Now this is a dope queen, except that's not the queen, that's the worker. This is our green-headed worker and her mom. It's like a colony of two, like a single mom situation. This is the Rhydipanera SP. I don't think she's a Metallica. She's not quite green enough to be a Metallica, but yeah, she's just investigating the cricket guts that was left for her. Pretty skittish. Probably one of the smaller Rhydipanera. Probably butchered that. Please tell me in the comments if I butchered that. But yeah, very cool semi-clustral ants that are found all over Australia, often called the backyard ants because of their prevalence. They've got a pretty nasty sting, and queens are actually quite uncommon, so I was quite lucky to get my hands on this one. They're quite famous for having gamergates, one of the few species that do have gamergate ants. So what that means for all you ignorants out there, there's the mom in the single mom household. What that means is that the workers can actually mate with males and start producing other workers, which is a bit of a scary thought, but gamergate colonies are a serious pain because you have to constantly go and fetch more males. And nobody got time for that, because the males die pretty instantly, and the gamma gates only last for a couple months, so your colony is always on the brink, which sucks. This disgustingly average ant is a Fidole worker. She's one of our many Fidole nanotics. I think this Fidole queen has 3 or 4 nanotics, and they are absolutely tiny. And not only that, they are incredibly lazy and pathetic. And they are so lazy that if you put the queen on a heat mat, she will literally cook to death instead of move her ass. So if you have a Fidole queen in a test tube setup and you've got a mold problem, I'm afraid it is a problem that you're going to have to deal with, because they will not move, and they would probably rather cook to death than move to a new test tube. So yeah, that's the challenge of owning Fidole, but it's pretty exciting that we've got some workers finally. It seems like it's been forever since we got these, about 3 months ago. Now onto something more exciting. These are our Nyland area, and look how many there are. There are hundreds. I reckon we've got about 200, and they've almost outgrown that nest actually, and always happy for a show, always hungry. These girls go through about a cricket a night at the moment, and boy do they love to put on a show. I've never had such active ants, and look at them tear this cricket to absolute shreds. Look at that one on top. She's tearing it so hard, it is literally dislodging her footing. And it took about 1 minute to get about 40 workers to the site, and there's a constant stream of about 20 at any point until it's literally nothing. These are our glaber. They suck. We got them at the same time as the Nyland area, and there's like 20 of them. They don't do much. Apparently they build paper structures, but they've been eating the paper, and all they've given me is that pile of poop in the corner. Now, this is a bit harder to see. It's like we're watching Jurassic Park or something, but these two are both Polyrhachis queens, I've been told. They better be Polyrhachis queens, and Polyrhachis are famous web spinners. And the nest is a bit dirty, but I'm kind of too scared to move them. Don't want to kill them. Quite expensive and pretty dope ants, so expect more from them in the future. And to wrap you guys up, this giant queen, this biggest queen we have actually, she's bigger than the Campanatus ones with the giant dent on her butt, is a meat ant. She's an Eridomyrmex purpureus, and she really doesn't like the light, and I was told they build colonies super fast and explosive growth, etc., but so far we've just got a couple eggs, and yeah. And absolutely last, just before we go, this is our black-headed strobe queen. She's got amazing eyesight, and they nest on the surface, and they're pretty small colonies, very very hard to find, very few people have them. Eli from Ant Invasion has a colony which is way more advanced than this one, so go check that out. But yeah, until next time guys, it's just a short quick one. This has been John from AntMate,